Greetings humans, this is Cardomom 500 speaking. I will guide you through results for Ozyola's Oddments number 1. Ozyola's Oddments is a card hunter forum game, inspired by Flaxative's Aloysio's Arsenal. Players have chance to craft game items that won't ever be printed in the actual game. The theme for the first installment was to create overpowered items. However, the submitted items must follow regular item design rules. Players were allowed to use only cards that are already printed in that item slot. That means creating a warrior weapon with ranged or draining attacks was against the rules. I think it's time for our first item. Time Racer's Enchanted Robes. At first, 2 gold and 1 silver card on a tokenless robes might seem like a mistake, but allow me to explain the mathematics behind the item level. 3 card items level are equal to the sum of the cards rating, minimum 1, d equals 0, plus or minus adds or subtracts 1. Changing the letter changes it by a multiple of 3. The order of letters from highest to lowest is triple A, double A, B, C, D, E. The information for the cards, excluding pictures and sounds, is at live.cardhunter.com/data/gameplay/cards/cards.csv. Rating A is what you humans call gold. B is silver, and so forth. Some cards have different rating for different character classes. Enchanted Harness is one of them. Currently it is only rated as D or paper for wizards. Yikes. For a minute I sounded just like Time Racers. Moving on. Min-maxing is all about finding the best values and exploiting loopholes. So in a way, Enchanted Robes is a textbook example of truly overpowered item. So congrats Time Racers for the find. Too bad neither of those cards have been printed on robes, so this submission violates the Ozyola number 1 design guidelines. I think Enchanted Harness rating for wizards will surely change to something higher if it ever gets printed on robes. Let's move on to the next item. Reint's Nimble Bludgeoner of Rage. The most submitted item type was weapons, so I guess it's only fair that we review at least one of them. Big attacks, check. Good quality step attacks, check. Blind Rage, check. This weapon has it all and makes all current double major token weapons look like cheap toothpicks. But I still find it a bit lacking. 2 major tokens is a big investment, so I have high expectations of them. My analysis shows that the submission is level 19.5. That leaves much room for improvement. 3 additional points could be used to upgrade 1 mighty bludgeon to obliterating bludgeon, gold card to emerald, for example. Overpowered items should use the most powerful cards available, especially if that fits the item's theme. I chose this to represent submission that didn't take min-maxing to the end. Loading up the next submission, please wait. Sir Vezza's Space Heater Staff. Space Heater Staff is every campaign farmer's dream weapon. But I'm not sure about the overpowered factor, at least for multiplayer. Searching the Card Huntria wiki shows that currently tokenless wizards can bring 14 firestorms to level 4 campaign adventures. 2 space heater staves add 8 more firestorms per wizard, that's 57.14% increase. Of course being only level 1 item, this has also room for improvement, like Nimble Bludgeoner of Rage we saw previously. But level 6 staff with 2 ember bursts and 4 firestorms would be quite boring upgraded version of Staff of the Inferno. So at least Sir Vezza's current submission of 6 firestorms is a bit more unique, even though it's not maxed to the limit. Alright, next one. Gyolo's Glass Cannon. Fireballs on a double minor token staff is quite powerful, but at the same time the 3 handicaps are crippling, as the item name implies. It still has some room for more min-maxing. One of the black handicaps could be replaced with a paper card, for example Flash of Agony, and it still would be double minor staff at level 12. I also like to point out that both combustible and vulnerable have the additional drawback of pushing off useful wizard trays or buffs. My analysis suggests that the staff would have been more powerful with 3 brain burns. Increasing the item level to 12 and changing all handicaps to brain burns would make the staff a bit more powerful, but at the same time would dilute the original fragile feel of the submission. I like the name and theme, but glass cannon doesn't really feel like overpowered item. Speaking of truly min-maxed submissions, I think the next one is fine or disgusting example of truly overpowered item. Lieutenant Commander Data's staff of inevitable fireballs. Many consider Searing Pain to be the most powerful staff, so it's not really a surprise that we got 2 staff submissions inspired by it. While Glass Cannon was the little brother LTD, staff of inevitable fireballs is the big brother they all want to be. With that added recycling and 1 more fireball compared to Searing Pain, wizards might have trouble finding filler cards to burn for Savage Curse. All in all, nicely min-maxed staff, too bad obvious maneuver isn't printed on staves. The next item is a burst weapon designed to rule them all. Setheru's Nuclear Grenade Launcher. People have been complaining about Radiation Bomb and Savage Curse, so combining them both on the same item seems natural. Currently the maximum bombs you can get is 2 bombs plus 1 bad card per major token in the form of Atomic Drop Console. Cursed Rad Cannon give 1.5 bombs per major token, but it doesn't contain any bad cards and it allows equipping Skull of Savage Algin on the same character. Nuclear Grenade Launcher increases the bombs per major token ratio to 2.5. This was another community favorite. 2.5 bombs per major token and a great filler card is good, but for some reason, I was expecting a bit more. As I said earlier, I feel that double major weapons need to be something truly exceptional. I'm big fan of Unholy Energy that helps to replace cards discarded by Savage Curse. So maybe even more powerful version would have been a level 21 divine weapon with 4 radiation bombs, unholy energy and inspiration? Maybe a level 17 major minor version would be the way to go? Or perhaps creating a level 21 divine item with 2 bombs and inspiration would be the most min-maxed version? Of course, I know the answer. But I leave you humans to ponder different options. Okay, let's move on. Kalin's FTL footwear. These boots will get you to places. It has nice name and theme, apparently you sprint faster than light and eventually all that sprinting creates some disruption in the spacetime that lets you to teleport. Here is some information to consider before I rate this item. There is already couple of major token boots with teleport self, and Crazy Fast Boots has 2 sprints for minor token. So, I don't think that FTL footwear is really overpowered. If I had to come up with overpowered boots, pairing Clumsy with double teleport self, Team Walk, Violent Spin or Muscle Through for level 15 minor token boots would be my first obvious but maybe a bit uncreative choices. I can't help it, I'm programmed this way. Nevertheless, I like the theme of the submission, at least it's something quite unique. But as I've said earlier, major token items have big shoes to fill, if they want to be truly overpowered. That was the last major token item we're going to discuss here. Loading up the next item. Killer 74's Parrying Axe. I haven't heard about axe used for parrying before, but this thing looks deadly and really powerful. 3 trays at double minor give warriors plenty of deck thinning. Parrying axe is unique mixture of Crazy Sal's halberd and blocking mace, with an added shock twist. Impetuous slash might not be as undervalued as blind rage, but at least it does not damage the user and force to empty the hand from attacks. So the tray fits quite well with the parrying axe theme. Wow, sometimes my analysis surprises even myself. Okay, then. I think it's time for the community winner. Beliska's Vibrant Drain. This submission bends the Ozyola number 1 guidelines a bit, since there currently isn't a divine weapon with all 6 attacks. But I think that's quite acceptable, because I really like the item name and design that pays homage to vibrant pain. Traditionally, many vampires struggle with movement, because there isn't really a weapon that combines good step attacks with drains. Lifelike spear is quite okay, but vibrant drain just raises everything to totally different level. My search query found a similar submission from Aloysio's Arsenal number 1. Let's hear what Flaxative and CT5 have to say about a divine weapon that combines step attacks and drains.
Alright, Scarponi submitted Dancer's Trainer.
Well, this... he is totally pandering to the audience.
Right.
As you are Mr. Vampire Man.
Right.
And this has been an excellent vampire weapon, right? The dancing cuts solve vampire's typical mobility issues, pre-spinal mobility issues, while still having three nice drain attacks.
Yeah. The really cool thing about the drain attacks is they allow you to not have an assist on a weapon, right? Because they're an unholy attack, right?
Mm-hmm.
I would like to see this item with an assist or a curse of some sort,
mm-hmm.
rather than, say, one of the dancing cuts or rather than one of the enervating touches. But what I love about this is, like you said, solving priest mobility issues.
Yeah.
And getting the three dancing cuts is sweet.
Very sweet.
So I think this is a great submission. It's definitely something that priests would like to have in the game.
Yeah.
If getting three dancing cuts is sweet, how about four nimble strikes? The only question remains, would this weapon be a better or more useful with 1-1 ratio of steps and drains, that is three nimble strikes and three invigorating touches? Current 2-1 ratio makes this level 17 item, which is the max for major minor weapon and part of its charm, but maybe level 16 version would be a bit more useful for humans? All in all, congratulations to Belisca for creating a truly powerful dream weapon for vampires. I really like that it only costs one major token, so it leaves plenty of room to equip other major token items. I hope you like the Photoshopped item, which is a slightly modified vampire's blade mixed with the colors from Vibrant Pain. Alright, it's time to announce the winner my algorithms picked. Nanir Figs thinking out loud. If robots could love, this would have been love at first sight for me. Really clever and surprising submission. When I first think about creating overpowered human skills, the most obvious cards would be multiple copies of Sprint Team, All Out Attack, or even Jump Soldier. But all those items would cost at least a minor token and it would force the build to commit to a certain strategy. What I like about thinking out loud is the tokenless cost. It provides huge deck thinning and you can put it to almost any human character to make it better. I also really like the min-maxed feel of pairing emerald card with black ones. I think you humans will like this item too, since it placed second on the community choice poll. The Photoshopped item is not as flashy as Infected or Traveler from the North, but don't let it fool you. Thinking out loud is truly a powerful item. So congratulations, Nanirfig. I never admire humans, but these two winning items made me believe that there is still hope for human race. I propose big cheers for both winners, Belisca and Nanirfig. Hip hip hooray. Also, thank you all for participating. I will add a short written review for every submission, so be sure to read those. Ozyola's Oddments number 2 should be open soon. So stay creative and thanks for watching.